With the ups and downs of gas prices, a lot of people have been searching for energy-efficient answers. And this past summer, two Purdue students went to the extreme, and with style, by creating this 1987 all-electric Porsche. Let's see what this thing can do. Well, that was awesome. Now let's talk to the guys that are responsible for making this bad boy come to life. Hey guys, how's it going?
Pretty good.
Thanks for letting me drive this. This was really cool.
No problem, man.
So how did you guys come up with this idea to create an all-electric Porsche?
We looked at like 10 cars on Craigslist. This ended up being the cheapest car we could find. We got it for $500.
That's pretty good for a Porsche. So how does this thing get charged up?
Basically, it just has an onboard charger, and right where you used to fill gas for it, there's now a plug for it. So you just plug it right into either 115 volts or 230 volts, whichever is available. We really haven't taken anything out in this car. It still works just like a normal car would. The only thing you've lost is air conditioning and power steering. We still retained power brakes. In order to do that, we had to create our own vacuum pump, whereas it typically would get a free vacuum off the internal combustion engine. And we still have radio, still have lights, still have everything that you normally would on a gas car.
Obviously, this has brought, you know, a lot of attention to you guys, you know, from the school, from media. You know, how's that felt?
It's been almost overwhelming because there's been a lot of people that have been contacting us, and it's been great, though, because it's just, I love showing off the car. It's just a lot of fun.
Actually, what we're working on right now is we're entering in the Burton D. Morgan business competition at Purdue for an electric vehicle conversion company. So we're hoping that if we win some money through that, we can do another conversion, upgrade to a brushless or AC motor, which would have regenerative braking and a lot higher efficiency. And then we could go with the lithium batteries too.
What's your favorite part about this car?
Well, just driving it, honestly. It's just such a different feel. It's just, I daily drive stick shift, and this is just completely different still. There's no idling to it, so you just get in and go. It's a lot simpler.
Mm-hmm. Is this your guys' day-to-day car?
We use it pretty often at Purdue.
Yeah.
But we don't really go very many places.
Well, thank you guys so much. This has been amazing. I didn't know this is how an electric car works, so I really appreciate you guys letting us take a look at it. Well, there you have it. We're not all about gold and black here in Boilermaker Land, but we also do it green. For Boiler Bytes, I'm Bree Swartz. And now, I have to get to class.